What would you do if I sang? I'm unpacking right now. My bike looks like it's in perfect condition, like the way I sent it. UPS, in fact, did not throw it around in a truck like they claimed it would. And I had shirts, nice shirts, double up as packing material. So I was very efficient in my packing methods. I just gotta take off all the tape. Oh, look, a sock! I can wear that later. Well, look, it's steel covers. Giggity. In here I got my wetsuit completely padded and protected. Leg one. I got my bike shoes with a lot of food that I'm gonna use. My race belt. My no cramp pills. Aero bars. Aero bar pads. See if it will allow me to have kids later on in life.
You didn't have any trouble packing it all in there?
If packing for 6 hours is no trouble, then no, but yeah. I'm a habitual cow stealer.
After putting his bike together, Jesse is having difficulty with his rear wheel. The wheel cover is rubbing against something, slowing the rotation.
That dog will hurt.
That sounds a little better.
There's something definitely wrong with this. I gotta call Richie.
The only thing is like when I tighten the thing now, like when I put it all back on my bike, it doesn't freewheel.
Like the yellow marks?
Uh-huh.
That was a moment of intelligence I had.
Do you use chalk or a pen or what?
It's like a paint pen.
I don't own one.
Thank you, Patrick, for owning one. It dries after like 10 seconds and reminds you of how to put your bike back together. Which otherwise would take an hour. But it looks like the bike was transported successfully. No big breaks in the frame. I got to see if the wheels are true. And I got my torque wrench to make sure all the bolts are tightened correctly. I figure this is going to take about 45 minutes. Probably should have done it last night if I was too tired.
Too busy watching Forrest Gump.
That's right. I think she's getting close. Feeling on this one. There it is. This thing works.
He's down in the wheel.
The free hub body had slipped off of the actual axle, and the wheel cover had slipped in between. So the cassette and the free hub body had the wheel cover in between and created that tension, so it wasn't able to spin freely. So it's fixed now, it's ready to go.
Jesse's
now we just have to ride it.
Jesse's a happy camper.
A very happy camper.
After waiting by the exit to T1, we were able to see everyone pass by, Jeff, Lenny, and Cheryl. But there was one missing. When Jesse switched to his sleeveless wetsuit, too much skin was exposed to the cold water and he became hypothermic. One of the assistants' boats helped him out of the water and allowed him to warm himself. The swim director warned him that if he ever went to another kayak for help, he would be forced to pull him from the race. Jesse got back in the water and swam as far as he could before he went hypo again. His race was over.
Jeff Chrissey!
The bike course is 3 out and back loops of almost 39 miles per loop.
Get some! You're doing it, man! Woo!
see him look at me?
Yeah. Like, what the? Here it comes. Let's go, Lenny!
One, two!
Woo!
So I'm here packing all my gear bags. I have five of them. Two special needs bags, one for the run, one for the bike. And I have two transition bags, one for the run, one for the bike, and a morning clothes drop bag. So what I'm doing right now is just trying to think, what do I need throughout the day and what do I need in particular bags, such that if I know I'm gonna feel a particular way, say during the run, halfway through, I'm gonna want some special food. So for instance, for the bike, I'm packing a Snickers bar on my bike that my mom gave me, special gift from her. And I think I'm gonna need that towards the latter end of the bike. So after 100 miles or so, I'm just gonna need a quick shot of nougatosity. In fact, here, let me show you. It says it right there, nougatosity. So that's gonna go on the bike. This is one of the things I'm gonna carry the whole time on the bike. Another thing is I got my power bar, which with its sticky properties is staying on the frame, and when I need to grab it, I can just rip it off. I've had a lot of problems where if you try to get a wrapper off something, say like these crackers, it's going to take a lot of work, and with the rain possibility on Sunday, fiddling with something while you're on your aero bars could result in a crash, so I'm not trying to take that risk at all. And then I have my my flask of caffeine hammer gel. This thing is full, and I'll probably use most of it. I've never used all of it on one ride, but I'm really hoping that placing it right here will remind me to take it often. And I'm gonna unpackage these crackers, but not all the way, because if it does rain on Sunday, I don't want these to get soggy before I go out on the bike. So,
what's your nutrition plan?
My nutrition plan is every 20 minutes, just take in something. So like a power gel, power bar, some crackers. After all the training, I've learned what I like and what I'll be able to process towards the end of a ride. And for me, that's crackers. These crackers can go the whole ride with me. But I do need a little bit of hydration with them. To eat them just plain is like that cinnamon challenge. Down all that cinnamon ain't gonna happen. You need to douse them first. So I'm gonna try to put as much food as I can on the bike. That way I don't have to grab them from people along the course at aid stations. And I have minimal pockets in my tri-kit, so I'm not going to be able to stuff a lot in there. And it's going to be a 5 hour and 45 minute ride, I think, so I'm going to need a lot of food. And in my gear bags, for instance, I got the shoes, I got arm warmers in there, gloves, a towel just in case I'm not dry enough yet. And after talking with Tommy here, I figured I would throw in my Pasadena Tri Club jersey in case I do want to throw some extra food and get some extra warmth at the very beginning of the bike. Since they're calling for rain and it might be very cold, I don't want to do a cool ride. And then I have my run bags, I have my shoes, I got a water bottle filled with Heed. It's good stuff. And then I have a run special needs bag. I think the only thing that's going to go in here is my Iron Man mask. I'm gonna try to run with that for the last half marathon, see how that goes. And then the morning clothes bag. This is for anything that I'm gonna drop before I get completely in my wetsuit and that I want returned to me by the end of the day, which I'll probably wear the same stuff after the race, after I come in and, you know, get very, very cold. And then last thing is bike special needs bag. I don't know if I'm gonna throw anything in here. I don't think I really need anything on the bike, unless there's extra food that I can't fit on the bike.
Extra crackers, maybe?
Extra crackers may go in here. In fact, good idea. So that's what I'm packing.
Are you going to put on chamois butter?
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to take a couple minutes. Okay. I think it's worth it. I'm going to do it egregiously.
I'm just going to raw dog it. and tell Elizabeth not to touch me for a couple of days.
Sounds about right. You can start a small brush fire with the heat you're going to generate down there.
Okay.
I got my bike. That's all I need. Oh, I got my bike and my wetsuit. That's all I need. I got my bike, my wetsuit, and my heart rate monitor. That's all I need. I got my bike, my wetsuit, my heart rate monitor, and my Ironman mask. That's all I need. I got my bike, my wetsuit, my heart rate monitor, my Ironman mask, and my body glide. That's all I need. I got my bike, my wetsuit, my heart rate monitor, my Ironman mask, my body glide, and my water bottle. That's all I need. I got my bike, my wetsuit, my heart rate monitor, my Ironman mask, my body glide, my water bottle, my bagel. That's all I need. I got my bike, my wetsuit, my heart rate monitor, my Ironman mask, my body glide, my water bottle, my bagel, my goggles. That's all I need. All right.
We're about 7:04. Lenny swam in 106. Got on the bike at 1:14. Did a 2:02 in the first loop, which would put him at 3:16. About 2 hours for the next loop, which would put him at 5:16. Making 2 hours to the next loop, which will put him at 7:16. So 7:16, 7:20, he'll come in transition to be ready for the marathon.
You
all right?
Thank you.
In T2, after completing the bike leg, athletes coast in the transition area and hand their bikes to the volunteers. After that, they're free to change and get ready for the marathon, as well as taking a few more calories.